Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about some geometry word problems today. And the first one says, how many square feet of flooring should be purchased to cover a hallway that is 4 feet wide and 18 feet long? Each box of flooring contains 2.8 square yards of flooring. So how many boxes are needed? So there's kind of two questions in there. One of them is about how much flooring that we actually need, and then how many boxes we need to purchase is the second part of that. So in order to find the area of a rectangle, which a hallway just 4 by 18, its area equals length times width. So the first thing would just be our length 4 times our length 18 times our width 4, and that gives us 72 feet to the second power, or square feet. Remember that when you take a two-dimensional object and find the area of it, you're going to get second power units. But the flooring is sold in the square yards, so the next thing we're going to do is change our answer, 72 square feet, into square yards. Now the conversion for square yards to feet, 9 square feet in 1 square yard. So I want to get rid of square feet. So I have 72 feet to the second power that goes on the top of my first fraction. This is called unit conversion. So I'm setting it up in this unit where the top unit equals the bottom unit but has different units. So I have 1 yard squared is equal to 9 square feet. And so the square feet on top and bottom here crosswise cancel out. And I have 72 over 9, which gives me 8 square yards. So dividing by 9 would change square feet into square yards. And so then, though, 8 square yards, and each one contains 2.8 boxes. So I would take those 8 feet and I would say, well, how many times does 2.8 go into 8? And that is 2.9. So you can't buy less than a full box. So that means we would have to round up, and then means that we would have to buy 3 boxes to complete the flooring job. Okay, so that is the first one. In the second problem, Peyton is planning to put molding around the base of his living room. The living room is 14 feet wide and 16 feet long, and there are 2 doors that are both 3.5 feet wide. So when we're talking about putting molding around a room, it's like a trim at the bottom. So it's not an area problem. It has to do with linear feet. So we're just going to add up all the 4 sides. The 4 sides of his room are 14, 16, 14, 16, if you walked around it, which is 60 feet. And the other way you may remember doing perimeter is saying there's 2 widths, which were 14, and 2 lengths, which were 16, and multiply that up that way to get 60 feet. And you notice that I'm just putting linear feet, which means feet to the first power, because we're not doing an area. But if you were putting molding around the bottom of the floor, the bottom of the walls there, you would not put molding across the threshold of the door. Everybody would trip on it. So then what you want to do is that you would take the 60 feet around and subtract off the 2 doors, which means you need 53 feet of molding to complete the job. Okay, a shoebox is 6 inches wide, 8 inches long, and 4 inches deep. What's the volume? So the volume for any kind of shape like that is just length times width times height. So I'm going to take 6 times 11 times 4, and then remember that when you multiply those things together, you have to think about your units as well. And this is 3-dimensional, so we have third power, so it's 264 inches to the third power. A medium pizza at Pizza Hut has a diameter of 12 inches, while the large pizza has a radius of 7 inches. What's the difference in area between the 2 pizzas to the nearest hundredth? So area equals pi r squared, and I know that if I take 2 radiuses, I get a diameter. So the relationship is diameter divided by 2 would give me a radius. So thinking about that 12-inch pizza first, it has a diameter of 12 inches, so we would cut that diameter in half to figure out that the radius is 6. So we have pi r squared, 3.14 times radius squared, and that gives us 113.04 inches squared. Again, if you're talking about area, your units are going to be to the second power. For the second pizza, we'll do similar thing. It's 14 inches across. but it's 7-inch radius, right? So the radius is 7, so if we double that, it has a diameter of 14-inch. So then we take 3.14 times 7 squared and get 153.86. Because I was asked in both of these to round to the 100th, that's where I'm going out to. And then for my final answer, they asked for what's the difference in those two. And the difference is the larger pizza minus the smaller gives us 40.82 square inches. That is the difference in amount of pizza that you get from a 12-inch pizza to a 14-inch pizza. And finally, the triangular street sign has a base of 30 inches and a height of 26. I've shown a picture over there. How much area is left for the message on the sign? I shouldn't have said is left, just how much area is there on the message for the sign. The area in square feet to the nearest hundredth, what is the area in square feet to the nearest hundredth? So they gave it to us in inches. So the first thing we're going to do is find the area of the triangle, which is just base times height, 30 times 26 divided by 2. And that gives us 390 inches squared. And then it says, what is the area in square feet? So we're going to do like we did up here where we have to change square units. And so it's interesting to remember, or important to remember, that there's 144 square inches in a square foot. Because if you think about a foot is 12 inches by 12 inches, and 12 times 12 is how we get the 144. So we have 390 inches that goes on top over 1, and our unit conversion here is 1 square foot is 144 square inches. The square inches will cancel, and 390 divided by 144 is 2.71 feet squared. All right, there's some examples of geometry problems, and have a fantastic day. I'll see you next time.